Good evening. A vigilante has been sentenced to 7 years jail for chasing a scared teenager to his death. Mitchell Chase was just 15 when the angry driver pursued him until he made a fatal mistake. His parents say they will be haunted by the knowledge that their son's last moments were full of terror.
To know that he was so scared is just absolutely, that's part of my nightmares at night.
18 months after their son was tragically killed, the parents of Mitchell Chase are consoled by dozens of family and friends as the vigilante driver who killed him was jailed. The 15-year-old scared into making a mistake that cost his life.
At 15, he's too young to have been taken from us, and he had such a bright future ahead, and we're just devastated to have lost him. We just hope that this is a lesson for anybody in the future that thinks of doing anything similar, like how much it hurts us and how much we struggle every day.
The man who killed him shouldn't have even been on the road. Unlicensed driver Jude Francis chased the teenager, wrongly believing the teen was riding his stolen trail bike. The pursuit was so terrifying it caused Mitchell to run a give way sign, hitting a car. He died a day later in hospital. The judge today called him a vigilante who was behind the wheel of a heavy, dangerous missile and struck fear into him when he decided to chase the teenager. The 26-year-old admitted after the crash he stopped to see if the bike was his, then left the scene when he realised it wasn't. This is Francis pursuing the trail bike just moments before the crash. What happened next? Too hard for his parents to see.
We just don't want to see that. We've never wanted to see it.
The court heard Francis told police he had no intention of hitting the bike because he didn't want to scratch it. But the judge said he made the decision to place the teenager in danger that evening, and he alone was responsible for causing his death.
Francis will be eligible for parole after 5 years and is banned from driving when released for another 3 years.
Hopefully I never come face to face with him, see him, or give as little time as possible to thinking about him. Just thoughts of my love for Mitch from now on.
Michael Stamp, Nine News.